Hello, YouTubers. It is Godzilla 294 here, coming at you another figure review. And this time it is on the NECA Atomic Blast Shin Godzilla. So, if you guys seen my unboxings, my first impressions, you know, I wasn't really a big fan of the figure. I'm still not, but it has grown on me in the past couple of hours. It's a cool piece to have. It's, like, kind of frustrating because the paint job is, we'll save that for later in the video. But anyways, the mouth, the new head sculpt is really, really nice. The teeth are actually all painted really, really well. And the inside of the mouth, it's really, really nice. You get different colors of purples, lights, and darks. And then you also have the white to make it look glowing, which is really, really cool. You can also see the port to plug in the atomic breath piece, but I'll show you that later. And it looks really, really cool. Like, this is the part that makes me happy about the figure, just the head sculpt, honestly. I really like the fact that they went, like, all out with the membranes, like, with the different colors. Because it looks so good. It just totally reminds me of the movie scene. Like, oh, it looks so good. Now, how to attach the atomic breath piece. Pretty much, you get two of them, obviously. And they're both... The atomic breath pieces are with metal rods to plug them into the tail and the mouth. But pretty much, the smaller one... The smaller rod is meant for the face, and the longer one is meant for the tail. Like, if you look at the promotional images, you can see which one is longer and which one's shorter. So, you know, kind of meant like that. But then, when you take it out, like, when you take the atomic breath piece out, there's always, like, some chalky paint coming off. Like, I don't know if it's from the atomic breath piece, or if it's from the actual, like, mouth or head of the tail. Like, I don't know. And, yeah, like, I don't know. I would be careful with atomic breath pieces for two reasons. They will easily chip, and if you display him with both pieces attached and he goes for a shelf dive, they're gonna probably break. Just being honest, they're gonna probably break. Like, the breath pieces are like a hard plastic, it's not even like a rubber, so like, it'll probably break. So now onto the paint job. The only good thing of the paint job, in my opinion, is the head. The head's paint is, like, so good. All the teeth are painted. The inside of the mouth looks really good. But once you start getting down to, like, the whole figure, like, the gills, the dorsal plates, the tail, the claws, the legs, it just doesn't look as good. Like, if you look at the original figure, it looks really, really good. Like, it looks good. Like, it actually looks like it does in the promotional images. Like, the red looks very evenly placed everywhere. It's kind of, like, glowing in a way with all, like, the black washes on it and the red washes. But with this figure, they did an SH Monster Arts move. They got red plastic and painted black over it instead of how they originally did it with black plastic and put red over it and some black and some paint in some areas. But it's just, like, if the figure was evenly painted, then I would have no problem. But I have one leg that's lighter than the other, and I have one side that's almost, like, too much red. And then I have one side that's, like, there's, like, very little red. And it's just, like, it's a whole bunch of colors. Like, like I said, if it was evenly painted, you know, then I would have not as much of a big problem. But it's just not. Like, I personally think this figure was rushed out of the toy factory, like, really, really quick. Like, this figure was announced before San Diego Comic-Con. And so they're already in production, you know, but it's just like, this figure was definitely rushed. Like, the dorsal plates, oh my god, like, the promotional images show the dorsal plates being so vibrant, glowing, like, and you get them and it's just like, no, it looks like really sad. Like, I had such high expectations for this figure because the promotional images set that expectation. Like, when you look at the original NECA Shin Godzilla figure promotional images, it'd probably say, like, maybe 90% of it looks accurate, like, to what you get in hand. But with this figure, it's probably 50% accurate compared to the promotional images. Like, we all know promotional images isn't what you get in hand, but this one isn't even close to it. It's not even close. Just the mold. That's pretty much it. Not even the paint job. The paint job is kind of crap. And, like, I want to paint it, but at the same time, it's just like, why am I going to paint a figure that's already supposed to come well painted? Like, I want to get another one to paint it in traditional Godzilla colors, like charcoal black skin with a gray wash, with a gray dry brushing, and like doing a blue atomic breath pieces, painting it myself, you know, doing all this glowing metallic blue and stuff like that. But it's just like, do I really want to? I don't know. It's just frustrating because they set their expectations so high for the promotional images, and I got way too hyped up for this figure. Like, it's a cool piece to have, don't get me wrong, but it's just like, why did you rush it? Like, you can tell it's totally rushed. Like, you can totally tell. And like, it kind of makes me mad that they rushed this figure, because it was supposed to come out in November, but they pushed it up to September, and now the NECA 1962 Godzilla is coming out in November. Hopefully, with them delaying it a month, the figure actually looks how it does in the promotional images, because that would be nice. Two good places of the paint, in my opinion, is the tail and the face. But besides that, it's really, really crappy. And like, when you look to the feet, one of the toes on him is like pointing like there's no tomorrow. And the other foot, the left one, it's painted like an olive green color. Like, there's not enough paint on it, so it makes it look olive green. And then going back to the other foot, there's like drippings left over of the paint, and it's really, 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 really bad. So now here's the comparison with the original NECA Shin Godzilla, and like, you can see the difference in quality and the difference in paint quality. Like, you can see this one is like way more shiny and stuff like that, and then the other one looks more like drier, matte, and you can see the difference in the paint quality too. Like, from one leg to the other one is kind of missing some spots, and the other one has like some nice washing on it. And if you guys saw my unboxing, my Shin Atomic Blast Shin Godzilla was wet. It was very humid in the box, and it was like very oily, and it was kind of like, ugh. He's not oily anymore, but he's still like really, really, really shiny. But here he is with the other figures, so you guys can see the comparisons. I personally think the Atomic Blast GMK Godzilla is way better, because it was unexpected. Like, the really, like, the blue highlights everywhere looks really nice. The translucent painted dorsal plates look really, really good. And then breath pieces is actually blue, unlike this one where it's just white with just a little hue of purple. And I'm kind of glad they didn't put purple hues, but it would have been nice to see like some like metallic purple on the legs and the arms and stuff like that. Like, just like a light dry brush over it to make it look really cool. But here he is with also the NECA leatherback and G14, just so you can see some size comparisons. And then also, on my tail, like, it's really like stubby and smushed in there, like some dorsal plates on the tail, and it's just like, it doesn't look good. So would I recommend this figure? If you're a completionist, yes. Or if you just want to not get the SH Monster Arts, then yeah, get this one. Like I said, it's a really, really cool piece, but if you can find one that's painted evenly, then go for it. Like, I ordered mine on eBay, so I wasn't able to choose my figure. And it's kind of like, also, like, I was really too hyped for it, so I didn't really care. Like, I just pressed order and, like, bam, you know? But it's like, if you find it at Target or at a collectible store, and you are able to choose your figure and see how the paint is, yeah, go for it. But if you're going to order it on eBay and Amazon, it's kind of risky, because you're just going to get a random one, you know? But, like, I have, like, very mixed feelings about this figure. Like, it's good and bad at the same time. Like, it's awesome and bad. Like, you just saw the video, you can see like the pros and cons of it, the quality, the concept, you know. It's really, really good and bad at the same time, so it's up to you. I mean, he is cheaper than the original figure. The original figure was like $28, this one is $25, surprisingly. But I mean, you can tell the price lower, it's just the quality, that's why. But yeah, anyways, please like, subscribe, comment, and share, and please let me know if you're gonna get this figure. And if yeah, thanks guys.